Now that you're familiar with the form basics and when to use each of the form editors, let's take a tour of forms on Ontraport Pages. This editor gives you the most powerful design options and settings, so let's take a look around. We'll take a general look at the layout first. In the Ontraport Pages editor on the left side, you're going to see different elements such as headline, buttons, images. Forms on Ontraport Pages use two of these different element types. Specifically, they use form fields and submit buttons. These two element types need to live in the same block in order to make a form. So if you decide to add a form field to a different block, that's going to start a second form. So make sure that you also added another submit button. Also notice that a button element and a submit button element are two different things. The first one is just a link that takes you to another page, while the submit button actually submits a form, and that's the one you're going to need here. To add a form field element, first click and drag it from the element palette on the left side of your screen. Then drop it into your page and a pop-up will appear asking you which field you'd like to add to the page. From that pop-up, you can pick any field that you've already created. So if you need to get a bit of info from your visitors, you'll need to first create a field to house the information in. You can learn more about this in our video called Where Your Data Lives. One quick note, depending on your account settings, you may actually see a different pop-up first when you drop a form field onto your page. This will ask you which object the form is for. Now, in most cases, you're going to select contacts, and then you'll see that normal form field selector that we were just talking about. But if you do want to collect information about a different data type, like deals and companies or any other custom object, you can choose that here. Once you've added your first field, it's time to open up your field settings and style it up. This will save you time because each field you add after this first one is going to copy its style. So if you take care of the style now, you'll only need to do it once. To open up your field settings, click on the field or the gear icon. On the left side of your page, you'll see your element palette change. It will say Form Field Editor, and it's going to display three tabs: Settings, Style, and Position. In Settings, you'll see several options. Contact field is where you can change the field you originally selected if you need to. Label will change what your leads and customers see on your form when they fill out the field. So for example, maybe you want the field to ask a question or phrase the information in a friendlier way, such as saying something like, "Tell us when your birthday is so we can send you something," instead of just a label that says birthday. This doesn't impact the way the information is stored in the contact record, however. Placeholder will create text inside the field for customers to see, almost like an example of the information you're looking for, and then it'll disappear when they begin to type into the field themselves. Maybe you're asking for something like a preferred prefix, so your placeholder might say something like Mr., Miss., Doctor., etc. Required field does exactly what you'd expect. It'll require the visitor to fill it out before clicking on the submit button. Just a quick note, it's a really good idea to require email address on all your forms. Under advanced, you can pre-fill a field with their existing data in some cases. This can save people time if they've filled out your forms before. Custom validation message will let you decide what message will display when somebody skips a required field. Next, let's look at the style tab. Now, the style tab lets you select from several preset style suggestions for forms or from your own favorites. Favorites can be added by clicking on this heart icon here. Or if you want to get fancy, click Edit Style to see even more options to customize the appearance of your fields. You can make changes to every detail. Let's take a look at our element design video to really understand your options here. Or feel free to experiment on your own. Selecting the Position tab allows you to adjust where the field will appear on the page itself. Something like a padding will adjust the space between the borders of an element and its contents. Margin is the space outside of the border of the element. Instead of changing the way the element looks by squeezing it, this setting will allow you to move the element around the page itself. All of this will be covered in our videos on element design in the Ontraport Pages section. Finally, to complete your form, drop in a submit button element into the same block as your fields, then click on the button or the gear icon to open up the settings, style, and position tabs for the submit button. Now, at the bottom of the left palette, you're going to find the form settings. You'll also find the same menu in the block layout mode in the left menu. Make sure you set these up before publishing the page and sending people to the form. You can learn more about that in our form settings and advanced features deep dive. When you're done with your form and your page is designed, you'll publish the Ontraport page and you're all set. And that wraps up our tour. Building forms on Ontraport Pages is the best solution for your forms in most cases, so you're off to a really good start. And if you do need more information on pop-ups and forms on non-Ontraport Pages, make sure you watch our video on Ontraport Forms.